Well, good morning, church family. Are y'all ready to do church this morning? Boy, that sounded robust. We got one gentleman here who is. What? Welcome to God's house. Yeah. Welcome to North Texas Trinity Cowboy Church, where we are blessed and you are blessed. It's a good time to be here. We just thank you guys for so much for showing up and worshiping with us and worshiping together. So anyway, let's stand up and do a little howdy neighbor.
Howdy neighbor, howdy, won't you come on in? We'll fix a pot of gravy to sop your biscuits in. And we'll take that banjo off the wall, let the music start. We'll sing them good old gospel songs, straight from Jesus' heart. Oh, come on in, sit right down. Have a cup of coffee and we'll pray. Come on in, sit right down. And we'll put some yee-haw in your day. How about some yee-haw? Howdy, neighbor, howdy. Won't you come on in? We'll fix a pot of gravy to sop your biscuits in. And we'll take that banjo off the wall, let the music start. We'll sing them good old gospel songs, drink them Jesus' heart. Oh, come on in, sit right down. Have a cup of coffee and we'll pray. Right down, we'll put some yee-haw in your day, some more yee-haw. Oh, come on in, sit right down. Have a cup of coffee and we'll pray. Come on in, sit right down. We'll put some yee-haw in your day. Gonna put some yee-haw in your day.
Oh, God, children, say, yee-haw.
Morning. So before I bring us open in prayer, tomorrow's Veterans Day. If you served in the United States Armed Forces, would you please stand up? That's you too, Christy. We can't thank you enough, and obviously some of them didn't make it back, so let's always keep them in our thoughts and prayers. Would you go with me in prayer, please? Excuse me. Lord Jesus, we come to you this morning thanking you for this beautiful day that you've given us and for the opportunity we have to be in your house, Lord, where we can gather with one another and praise and worship you, Lord. I pray for the band behind me, Lord, that they worship in the Holy Spirit, bring in the Holy Spirit to us, Lord. And I pray that you be with Brother Michael as he brings the message, Lord, that through him as a conduit that we can all receive what you have to say through him. Lord, lead, guide, and direct us in all that we do. Forgive us our sins, and Lord, when we fail you, I ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. by and by we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by.
This is one of the few times in the year I get to do some haggard and can't get in trouble for it.
I hear people talking bad about the way we have to live here in this country. Harping all the wars we fight, griping about the way things ought to be. Well, I don't mind them switching sides and standing up for things they believe in. When they're running down our country, man, they're walking on the fighting side of me. Well, they're walking on the fighting side of me. Running down our way of life, or fighting many fought and died to keep. If you don't love it, leave it. Let this song that I'm singing be a warning. When you're running down our country, man, you're walking on the fighting side of me. Well, I read about some squirrely guy who claimed that he just don't believe in fighting. And I wonder just how long the rest of us can count on being free. Well, they love our milk and honey, but they preach about some other way of living. When you're running down our country, man, you're walking on the fighting side of me. Well, you're walking on the fighting side of me. Running down our way of life, or fighting men have fought and died to keep. If you don't love it, leave it. Let this song that I'm singing be a warning. When you're running down our country halls, you're walking on the fighting side of me. Well, you're walking on the fighting side of me. Running down our way of life, or fighting many fought and died to keep. For if you don't love it, leave it. Let this song that I'm singing be a warning. When you're running down our country halls, you're walking on the fighting side of me. When you're running down our country, man, you're walking on the fighting side of me.
Church family, I have your upcoming announcements. Wednesday is our Wednesday night service. Thursday, November the 14th at 2 p.m. is intercessory prayer at Jenny Charles's home. Her address is on your pamphlet. Saturday, November 16th is the women's breakfast here at the church. And Tiffany, you wanted to talk about? All right, thanks, Tiffany. G6 setup is going to be Sunday, November 24th at 2. And it operates from Monday the 25th to Wednesday, December the 11th. We'll be out there from 10 to 8. There's a sign-up sheet in the on the back table to sign up for any shifts that you could do. Would be extremely helpful because we want to have, you know, a group of people out there at all times. And then the distribution is Saturday, December 14th. And so we'll need a lot of help with that, I believe, as well. So if you have any questions on that, you can see me, Dana, Stephanie, and we can help guide and direct you for that. Don't forget our backpack program. They'll need individual servings of stuff, especially with the holidays coming up. The kids are out of school, long weekends, long weeks. So anything that you can do to help out with that, there's a box in the foyer for that. The T-shirts for the women's team, they are in, and if you ordered one, you can see Teresa, and she will get that for you. And then there's a sign-up sheet for anyone interested in a North Texas Trinity Cowboy Church T-shirt as well. It's back there, the sign-up is. Did I miss anything? Okay, the men's breakfast will be... Okay, the men's breakfast will be out at G6 and November the 30th. Anything else? All right, you know what time it is. Time to shake hands and hug necks.
Thank you. Yeah. Doing it.
Trump had said, now through history, if you last, it's a mystery, but I guess they don't know what they're talking about. From the mountains on down to the plains, it become such a habit for me. America, America. Well, I come from down around Tennessee, but the people in California are nice to me. America. Well, it don't matter where I may roam, tell you people that it's home sweet home. America, America. And my brothers are all black and white, yellow too. And the red man is right to expect a little from you. A promise and then follow through, America. And the men who fell on the plains and lived through hardship and pain, America, America. And the men who could not fight in a war that didn't seem right, you let them come home, America. And my brothers are all black and white, yellow too. And the red man is right to expect a little from you. A promise and then follow through, America. America, America. America, America. Home sweet home, America, America. If tomorrow all the things were gone, I worked for all my life, and I had to start again with my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, Detroit down to Houston, and New York to L.A. This time they'll be, and it's time we stand and say. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me, and I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. And I'm proud to be an American. Well, at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I'm glad they stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
All right, let me have all the kiddos down here. Pearl, are you coming down here? Oh. Look at all these kids. Y'all say hello to the Smiths over here. All right. Front row Smith. How are you, sweetheart? Man. You are gorgeous. Did you eat a donut? Huh? Did you eat a donut? All right. Ain't she pretty? Y'all are all good looking. You know that? You forgot my chocolate. That's okay. Can you get some pawpaws and get them to me? Okay. All right. Did y'all have a good week? Everybody loves school. Braxton, you love school, don't you? I know you do. You love school. Hey, you know what? Hey, there's... This doesn't stink, okay? Look here. Bill, you might need to open the door, but no. See this boot? Do you see anything wrong with it?
No.
What is it, Braxton? Well, it's green, yeah. What's wrong with it? Nothing? Tate, how are you? You good? Look at him. Yeah. He got some shoes on. All right. See this boot? Now. There is something wrong with it. All right. Huh? It doesn't smell. Hold on. Look, this heel's wore out. Ever since I was a kid, I was always told to pick up my feet, and I never have. So I drag them, and I got about, I don't know, 8 pairs of boots that are wore out, okay, on the heel. See how this was done, knocked off of it, see? No, just usually one. I usually drag 1 foot for some reason. I don't know. I drag my feet. Never learned. You drag your feet too? So when you say dragging feet, sometimes that means you're being slow, but I'm quick, just dragging my feet while doing it. Hey, so if you see here, the heel's gone off of this thing. And when you sit it down, it's a little bit lower in the back, isn't it? There's not any support there. And see, I'm gonna take it off. See, it's got glue. I'm gonna take it off. See that? All right, I'm gonna take it off. I didn't break it, but the intention is, look, I got a new one. I may go into building boots. I don't know, but they won't be. Who knows what I'll do? But I just love doing a little bit of everything. So I said, you know what? Instead of taking them somewhere, I'm going to put them on myself, you know? So, why is my hand shaky? Because I drank too much coffee. So, I put it right here, and I'm going to put it on there, all right? So, yeah, I got to glue it and all that good stuff and make it look nice. But I'm going to glue it on there and do put a little tacks on there, all right? So, I got to think, I saw this, and I was like, you know what this is all? To me, this means that we... How many times you go to school and somebody says things that are mean to you? All the time or sometimes? And don't really build you up? Right? That don't really add to you sometimes? That are kind of ugly sometimes? Kind of put you down? Do you ever hear things like that aren't nice? You know? But you know what God tells us to do? Kind of like putting this, see how I was worn down? And God tells us to lift each other up. Kind of like this heel I'm going to put on there. Because when I put this on here and I stand up, what's going to do, Braxton? It's going to lift me up, ain't it? So a little thing like this heel is going to lift me up, right? Yep. So with that, you know what that means? That when we say things, we're to lift each other up. You know why? Because that's what God called us to do. I have two scriptures. Two scriptures I'm going to share with you. All right? This one I call speak good stuff, all right? Speak good stuff. When we lift each other up, we lift ourselves up too. So when you lift somebody up, there's that spirit that comes inside you that lifts you up as well because you're doing what God calls us to. It says this, do not let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouths. You know what unwholesome talk is? Talking, yeah, mean stuff. Talking bad about somebody because we're all God's children. Do not let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouths, but only what is helpful for building others up according to their needs, that it may benefit those who listen. So when you put a little bit into somebody, it lifts them up a whole lot more. So this little heel on here, it's not very much. It's less than half an inch, but it's going to lift me up. When I get this done, I'm going to walk better. I'll still drag and have to do it again, but you know what? It lifts me up for a little while. You know that? So that little heel lifts this whole big boot up. And this is a pretty, I've got big feet, so it's a size 13. But it that little heel lifts me up. So what you when you say something real nice to somebody, just a little bit, good morning, how are you doing? Man, that shirt looks good. You're looking sharp. You're beautiful. You know, guess what that does to that somebody right off in the morning? You got one more scripture. It says there, therefore, it's in Thessalonians, therefore encourage one another and build each other up just as in the fact you're doing. So try that tomorrow when you go to school, all right? Even if somebody is ugly to you and they may say something mean, hey, you look, you know, whatever it may be. If you don't go to school tomorrow, yeah, good. Anyway, so if you start off tomorrow or the next day and somebody says something maybe not good for you, lift them up anyway, okay? Say, hey, you're good looking today. You look sharp. It's going to be a great day for you. God bless you, okay? Can y'all do that? You can? Can you do that for me? And you'll be amazed what you can do in somebody's life. Just by, as children, what you can do to people's lives by just saying, hey, you sure are good looking this morning. Or bright and early, just say, hey, it's going to be a great day. God blessed us, right? All right, I'll say a prayer. Dear Lord, thank you for these kids. Thank you for what they mean to this church and the growth. The new growth that's coming out. Thank you, dear Lord, for who they are. Thank you for just blessing us with these kiddos. Pray that each and every one in here will be able to lift these kids up. And as we walk through this week, that we may find somebody that we can lift up in our words as you call out in your word to lift others in what we say, and that we watch our mouths and let no unwholesome words, but only good words to each other, and that we may show that we are Christians and that we want to follow what you teach us in your word. I just pray that you be with Ms. Dina and those who teach these young children. May the Holy Spirit come upon them and that they may be able to learn and grasp the knowledge of you, dear God. Pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
We got the Smith Row. I'm going to tell you something. When that little girl taps on James and says, you're in my chair, what do you do? You get up. I saw it. It's awesome. I do. She can come up here and I'll set it on. Now, we just want to. talk to you a minute. What we do, we'd have what we call praises and prayers, and I liken it to being at the dinner table with your family and discussing what all has gone in your life, the good stuff and the bad stuff, and then we pray about it. Anything that needs prayed for, we pray about it. So we're going to do that now. Anybody got a praise this morning? Go for it. Happy birthday, Mom. Who else got something? Bob.
I got a praise.
Go for it. There you go. Okay. Janet Stalder. Janice. Go for it.
Birthday. I know it's hard to believe, but I got a 32-year-old daughter got a birthday today.
Hey. Happy birthday. Anybody else? Anybody? Go ahead, Jamie. Praise for the rain. Man, we needed that. For sure. Josh. God bless America. Bless those Marine Corps, too. Today's their birthday. Am I right? There you go. There you go. Who else? Who else got something they need to pray for? Go ahead. We are.
I went to see Miss Wanda on Thursday, and Shelly went with me, and she is doing good for all these people that maybe are not on Facebook and didn't see her picture, but she is seemed happy, and we wore her out a little bit, so she's ready to go back home, but she is doing well, and I call her every day or every other day. I was told that she has had so many phone calls, she's forced.
That's true.
She's doing well.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just, it's different not having Miss Wanda here. She's still here in our hearts, so I promise you. All right, Ned. Got that, Jacob Pruitt. There you go. It's a good day when you open your eyes. What else? Anybody? Tiffany. We're going to pray for that group of people, and God bless you for doing what you do. I don't know how you do it. Yes, sir, you have one?
Yeah,
you go ahead.
Family, and so that makes it difficult. And then not only that, I was in semi Thank you, Ethel. Yes, sir.
She's also going to have maybe lower back surgery next week or two.
Mm-hmm.
We need to put her on the program.
You got that?
Yeah.
Yeah. There's a praise sitting right over there. She just came out of surgery the other day. Good to have you back. Proud everything went well. Sure am. Anybody else? I don't want to leave anybody out. Yeah, Dennis. Yeah, he was having a bad day yesterday. So we'll keep them lifted up. Mickey and Sharon. Travel mercies. All right, then. I'm going to pray us out, and we'll get Mr. Everett up here. Father God, thank you so much for the blessings you've given us. Thank you for this church house that we can come in and gather together in your name and worship you and pray to you, Lord. We just thank you so much for that, Lord. We ask that you put your hand on all of these folks who need healed, any kind of medical issue or mental issue, anything like that, Lord. We just pray that you heal them up. We pray that if there's someone out there who needs to know you, that they will lift up their hearts this morning and accept you into their lives and start their relationship with you, Lord. We just pray for everybody. Thank you so much for our country, Lord, and those who protect it and keep us safe and keep us free. I say this in Jesus' holy name. Amen. Everett, that row over there is on you this morning. Okay.
I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing, but I'm already taking this coat off because I'm hot. Huh. Y'all may be here a while. No, I'm just kidding. But I am hot. Man, I guess it's been about 2 months since I was having breakfast one Monday or Tuesday morning with Brother Ken. And I was thinking, he had already told me I had preached well over 50 sermons or so over the last 5 years. Basically, about once a month when it works out, whether it's on a Sunday or a Wednesday night or whatever. And I was thinking, I've never done a Veterans Day sermon. I thought that was a good idea. Well, about a month and a half into writing a sermon, no, Ken, I didn't throw it away. However, I did put it away. I had learned years ago, Ken, he's taught me well, we preach the gospel. This isn't about me. We do not come to church to be entertained. Heaven help you if you come here to hear me tell you war stories. I was debating whether or not that I would include that last verse over there. Down there, that's Proverbs 3:31. Do not envy a violent man. Choose not any of his ways. I must have skipped over that somewhere in my childhood. I grew up in the company of old men. Vietnam War was raging. Had uncles who had served. Had uncles who had served in World War II and Korea. I listened to way too many stories. I get to see life in living color up close. People talk about nightmares. Nah, I don't have them. I have flashback with my eyes wide open. That's not what we're talking about today. The title of this morning's message is Guard Your Heart. For so many years, I've heard people talking about follow your feelings. That statement couldn't be any further from this Bible. Drives my blood pressure through the roof. Hopefully, I can drive it into your head. Get your theological background from reading your Bible. If you would, join me in opening prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, happy name. Thank you for another opportunity to share your word. May my words be your words. May I speak clearly. Touch some hearts. May we all learn to follow you. Trust you. These things we ask for in your son's name. Amen. I'll venture a guess that every vehicle in that parking lot has an owner's manual in the glove box. Every one of them. And just like everybody else, what's the first thing you do when your car breaks down on the road? More than likely, you call somebody. Tell the truth. Call your friend. Call a family member. Call your favorite mechanic. You back there. Yet, that owner's manual is still sitting in the glove box collecting dust. When you first got that car, you probably went through it, how to make all the little buttons work. You were excited. Kind of like when you became a Christian. On fire. Wanted to know everything about it. Over the years, the car got mileage. Over the years, you got mileage. Does anybody know how many Bibles are in this church this morning? I don't. Once upon a time, weird habits. I would actually count them. I would actually watch people when they come in. We walk through life telling everybody that we're Christians, but we never look in the owner's manual. Kind of amazing. Just for the record, when I break down on the side of the road, I don't check the owner's manual either. Brother Ken know who I call. And if I can't get him, depending on the time, I'll wake up Will Ford back there in the back. I know they'll answer the phone. The same can be said about Jesus. Maybe when you have a problem in life, don't ask your friends. Don't ask the person next to you. Go to God. If you would, if you got a Bible handy, Jeremiah 17:9. The heart is the most deceitful, is more deceitful than all else, and is desperately sick. Who can understand it? Yet people tell you to follow your feelings. Those are my words. Inspired words of the prophet Jeremiah. The things you read in your Bible are not going to show up in a self-help book. Follow your heart, trust your feelings, are the kind of things you're reading a romance novel or find on the old Hallmark Channel. The Hallmark Channel will have you believing that the true meaning of Christmas is some lonely woman moving back to Montana to help her dying dad. We're getting to the happy ending, but first she has to help her dad save the family ranch. And you know what happens? She meets her old high school boyfriend who just happened to still be living in that one-horse town. They reconnect. They get married and live happily ever after. Don't. Man, that's all we need is tattletales. Jeremiah wrote that passage, I don't know, several thousand years ago. Yet it still applies today. Just food for thought. Do you really think people have changed over the last 3,000 years? Just because we have Facebook, social media, and all that other kind of stuff, people are still the same. Hi. I see new people. Hope y'all come back in spite of me. What was sin in the age of Noah is still a sin today. People didn't listen to Noah. What happened? Flood. Everybody got washed away. Do people listen to their pastors today? Sometimes. Let's fast forward a little bit up to the age of Solomon. Solomon prayed for wisdom. God made him the wisest man of all time. Solomon is given credit for writing at least three books, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Song of Psalms. But did he always get it right? No. Solomon was just like everybody else. He fell short of the glory of God. However, Solomon did write this, Proverbs 4:23-27. Watch over your heart with all diligence, for from it flows the spring of life. Put away your deceitful mouth and put devious speech far from you. Let your eyes look directly ahead. Let your gaze be fixed straight in front of you. Watch the path of your feet, and all your ways will be established. Do not turn to the right. Do not turn to the left. Turn your feet from evil. Fairly long passage, but it's important. That's Old Testament. No need to flip over to James. I didn't list a verse. James tells us that out of our mouth flows what fills the heart. If your heart is full of Jesus, if your heart is full of God, why do cuss words come out of your mouth? We're guilty. How did that stuff end up in our heart? We look to the left, we look to the right. We let our feet take us places we didn't need to be. We let our ears hear things that we didn't need to hear. Hope this doesn't come as a news flash. If you waller with hogs, let's roll around in the mud in case you don't know. You'll smell like a hog. You'll look like a hog. You'll oink like a hog. And then you'll act surprised when people call you hypocrites when you act just like one. It is what it is. Before we get out of the Old Testament, how about another Proverbs? I think I put 28 up there. Yeah, Proverbs 28:26. He who trusts in his own heart is a fool, but he who walks wisely will be delivered. He who He who trusts in his own heart is a fool. Didn't I just say all those self-help books tell you to do what? Follow your heart. I'm not a theologian. I'm just a guy that ran from God for a long time. I'll come back to it. If you think I'm being a little harsh, let's check out what Jesus had to say about your heart, about your mouth. Matthew 15:18-19. But things that proceed out of the mouth comes from the heart, and those defile the man. A lot of people will tell you about the things you eat will defile you. It's what comes out of your mouth, not what goes in. For out of the heart comes evil thoughts, murderers, adulteries, fornications, theft, false witness, and slanders. That pretty much sums it up. Evil thoughts, murderers, adulteries, fornications, thefts, false witness, and slanders. There are no new concepts in the Bible. In the Old Testament, they called it a sin, and the New Testament is still a sin. Sin hasn't changed. God's view on sin hasn't changed. Earlier, I asked the question, do you think we have changed over the last 3,000 years? I don't know. Maybe our viewpoint on sin has changed. Is there any such thing as a small sin?
No.
Is there a medium-sized sin?
No.
Is there a big sin? Thank you. We've all fallen short of the glory of God. He set the standard. We did. He set the standard. Oh, me stealing an ink pen out of here. This brother Ken's, he wouldn't mind. I'll bring it back next week. Stealing. Commit murder. All of them. There's no such thing as a small one and a big one. Last week, Pastor Ken had mentioned that basically that becoming a Christian is relatively easy. Believe in your heart. Take Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Repent. That's the easy part. You can do that in a blink of an eye. The hard part. The hard part is walking with Jesus every day. This is what Jesus had to say. Luke 9:23. If anyone wishes to come after me, he must deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow me. I've been walking with Jesus for well over 50 years, I guess. Don't be impressed. I know people have been walking with Jesus longer than I've been alive. I would assume that everybody in this room would have heaven as a destination. But we're all on different paths. We're all searching for that same narrow gate, hoping that it'll get us there. My path's been uphill, downhill. Some of it's been smooth. A lot of it's been rough, twists and turns. Ended up going the other direction a few times. I have spent years in the darkness. I spent years in the light. As for being in the darkness, that's a choice. It's a choice. Take Jesus as your Savior. Find your little light in the distance. Stay on the path and walk that way. Life happens. Jesus does not promise you a new Cadillac, big house, 2.3 kids. None of that stuff. Where they find the prosperity gospel, I don't know. I've been through my Bible way too many times. You follow Jesus, people will hate you. Society will hate you. Society will mock you. We had a presidential candidate who actually told somebody more or less to shut up when they said, Jesus is Lord. Yes. If you think people love you because of your faith, I got news for you. They don't. In Luke 9:23, Jesus said three things that you had to do if you wanted to be one of his disciples. You need to first deny yourself. Number two, you had to take up your cross daily. Number three, you must follow Jesus. Did he say follow your heart? No. He said follow him. You got to follow Jesus. Over that last 50 years, I've had problems with at least one of those three things every day. At least one of them. Some days I've had trouble with two. So it shouldn't be surprised that at some point in my life, I've had trouble with all three of them at one time on the same day. Every last one of them. Point number one. I'm not the center of the universe, so it's kind of hard to say I denied myself. I thought I was the center of my universe. Do you know that without love, your life is meaningless? Your life is meaningless. Some of you people I've known for years, some of you I've just met, I want to see all of you in heaven, every last one of you. If I do not see y'all in heaven, what am I doing up here? It's just that simple. Get to heaven, talking to Jesus, having that little powwow, and I see you in another line that's not going to heaven, going to the other place. And he asked me, why didn't I share the gospel? I was busy. What kind of response is that? I had to go to work. I had something else to do. Sunday morning, I saw people fishing this morning. Those fish could wait. Chances were they ain't catching nothing anyway. There's just two boats out there. The fish can wait. People who worked on a farm, especially if you've ever done dairy cows, your days start early. You milk those cows, feed those cows before you go to school. You mess with those cows before you go to your job. You can still make church. Those fish can wait. Point number two, take up, whoever follows Jesus needs to take up his cross daily. Well, I've been that Sunday morning only kind of Christian before. Get up, make, keeping the Sabbath holy. make it to church. Amen, brother. Good to see you. Peace be with you. The whole nine yards. I was 19 once, and it used to irritate me to death that Reverend Johnson would preach over till about 12, 15. That was back when I loved the Dallas Cowboys. Church was across town, and he would just talk and talk and talk. I wasn't thinking about Reverend Johnson after about the first 15 minutes. I got to go. Don't be that kind of Christian. Take up your cross daily, not just on Sunday morning. Monday morning, Tuesday morning. They're all coming. Probably the one that stabs me the most, hurts me the most, is the follow me part. I knew when I was a preteen that I was called into the ministry. But how many preteen boys want to be ministers? Well, two of my high school classmates, they started preaching immediately upon graduation. One has gone on to be with the Lord. The other one still preaches. Four, five, six of my college classmates went into ministry immediately upon graduation. They didn't go become engineers, doctors, lawyers, Indian chiefs. A couple of those guys actually ended up in Asia, preaching, doing ministry work in Indonesia. Not me. I didn't want to go to Asia. Yeah. 5 or 6 years after I got out of college the first time, I found myself in Southwest Asia fighting in a war, singing hymns. Singing hymns to my battle buddies, having church. You can run from God. But he'll still put you wherever he wants you. Somebody probably needs to hear this. Stop running from God. I don't know who you are. But stop running from God. You've heard my excuses for not denying myself. You heard my excuses for not taking up my cross daily. Heard my excuses for not wanting to follow Jesus. Jesus has something to say about my excuses, and you can find them over in Luke chapter 9. The passage is 57 through 62. Let me read you a few verses of it. As they were going along the road, someone said to him, I will follow you wherever you go. And Jesus said to him, printed in red in my Bible, the foxes have holes and the birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. And Jesus said to another, follow me. But he said, Lord, permit me first to go and bury my father. But Jesus said to him, allow the dead their own to bury their own dead. But as for you, go and proclaim to everywhere, to everyone, the kingdom of God. That entire passage should get an ouch. If you follow Jesus, you may not have a place to sleep. I've been blessed. The kid who ran away from God for years always had a roof over my head. I always had more than I needed. And regardless of how important you think your excuse is, that is pretty harsh when Jesus tells that guy, allow the dead to bury their own dead. So whatever excuse you got for not following Jesus, just ain't cutting it. As we celebrate another Veterans Day, I was debating whether or not I would do this somewhere in here. Cute little Tupperware box. It got, let's see. More importantly, for you military guys, my DD-214. Ethel, you laugh. Do not lose this. It almost takes an act of Congress to find another one. But a box of knickknacks of the stuff I gathered over 2 years. Mind you, I was in the Army longer than 2 years. Infantry Corps, French something, stack of ribbons, some more citations and that wonderful kind of stuff. In a 2 year period, I was probably the most dedicated soldier on the planet Earth. Blind dedication. Blind. If there was a better soldier on the planet Earth, I probably didn't meet him. Strange, because I had filled this box up in 2 years. I had a 4-year commitment, which I did. But it wasn't that important anymore. I'm not ashamed of anything in that box. And, whew, there are war stories in it. The reason that stuff is in this box is because I had blind dedication to the U.S. government, to the U.S. Army. I wish I had 2 years of blind dedication to Jesus. If we had blind dedication to Jesus, those 12 apostles who went out, they died. The first 100 years of being a Christian, you were going to get martyred. The Apostle John is the only one who died of old age. But before he died of old age, he was boiled alive. He didn't die. He spent most of his life in prison on Patmos. when he was 92-ish or so, they let him out. Can you imagine being in prison till you're 92? Dedication. Who do you follow? Follow your feelings or follow Jesus? If you haven't taken Jesus as your Savior, today is a good day. If you would, join me in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, have been named. Thank you for another opportunity. Touch your heart. Help us and guide us as we move forward. But we remember what's important. May we deny ourselves, take up our crosses daily, and truly follow you. What's the most important thing? Make us strong. These things we ask for in your son's name. Amen. Play us out here, Brother Dan.
Thank you, Michael. Thank you for your service. Thank all of y'all for your service. What a blessing. As always, I love you. God loves you. We'll see you next Sunday or Wednesday night. If you haven't ever been here on a Wednesday night, we have a party. No, it's a good time. If you have a special prayer request, come see Bob. He'll be over here in a minute. And Tiffany over here. Anyway. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know life is worth the living just because he because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know one more time. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know he holds the future.
life is worth the living just because he is. Life is worth the living just because he is. Y'all have a blessed day.